is 748-5218 today. That does it. Thank you very much for watching. And enjoy the tour. It starts right now. I fully invested in the show. We told them actually won the election in 2016. He lost the election, and he was put in office because the Russians interfered on his behalf.
Did you read President Trump as an illegitimate president?
Things on what I just said, which I can't retract.
Good morning, and welcome to AM Joy, live from Los Angeles. So I think I say this every week, actually every day, every hour, that we are living in extremely abnormal, unprecedented times. What you just heard and what you just saw was a former president of the United States questioning the legitimacy of the current president of the United States. That has never happened. Even when former presidents notably despised their successors, that has never happened. Former President Jimmy Carter went there Friday while talking about Russia's interference in the 2016 presidential election. He said it at an event hosted by the Carter Foundation, where he's established himself as a unique moral voice among former presidents. Carter's absolute rebuke came on the same day that Donald Trump had his first face-to-face meeting since the end of the Russia investigation with Vladimir Putin. A meeting at which Trump once again publicly genuflected before Putin, defended him, and even joked about needing to warn Putin not to attack our election again. Message, please, sir, please help me by attacking our election again. Right now, Trump is in South Korea for meetings with President Moon Jae-in, who is not a dictator, so Trump will probably not grovel in front of him. What Trump really seems to want is a photo op with murderous North Korean dictator Kim Jong-un. Here's Trump, tweeting out a plea for Kim to please come and hang out at the DMZ. Please, please, come and spend time with me and take selfies. And here's Trump bragging about the possibility of such a meeting early this morning.
Well, it might happen tomorrow. I think it could do that. We won't call it a summit, we'll call it a handshake. If it does happen. I don't know that it will, but it could happen. I know, I think he'd like to do it, and I wouldn't mind doing it at all. He follows my Twitter.
He does.
It's very hard. Yeah, I guess so, because we got to call it very quickly. A lot of people follow it. But you know, they contacted us and they'd like to see what we could do. So, I mean, we're not talking about for, you know, extended, just a quick hello.
Oh my God, he follows me on Twitter. Would it be friendship bracelet? Joining now is Dana Bechtel, former CIA analyst and author of The Targeter. Malcolm Mann, MSNBC contributor and author of The Plot to Destroy Democracy. Sarah Kendzior, scholar of authoritarian states and author of The View from Flyover Country. Former State Department advisor Naira Haque, and NBC News senior international correspondent here from Germany. Go to you first. What's the takeaway so far from Donald Trump at the G20?
Well, there are so many, Joy, I guess. I guess one of them for me is just the shamelessness. I remember previous G20s when President Putin left early because he was shunned by so many leaders. You remember last year the conference of Saudi Arabia shunned. This time, President Putin, the Crown Prince, front and center, the Crown Prince standing next to President Trump at that family photo. So, you know, you really saw those kinds of leaders.
Thank you, Susan, for watching. Poodle Palace. We thought about calling it the Poodle Palace.
And again, Julia, I remember President Putin being furious that he thought...
Bounce a lot is silly.
...might have intervened in some way in his election, and there he is laughing with President Trump about the idea of election meddling. So, I mean,
there was... Renee, can you believe how big Sabrina's getting?
With all that noise, though, I will say one thing. President Putin just in an interview declared liberalism as obsolete. In fact, you saw the Europeans, the leader of the United Nations, standing up for liberalism here. Perhaps their voices weren't heard as clearly as they may have been in previous times, but for that, you know, liberalism is not dead. And then a last piece, I guess, Joy, is that, you know, you saw this deal with the Chinese today after meeting with President Xi on trade. You talked about President Trump now heading to South Korea, hoping to be the change of land. It seems to me that President Trump's foreign policy is shifting a little as we head towards the 2020 elections. He wants to wrap things up, I suspect. In many places, he certainly is likely to not want a fight going into those Senate elections, going to want to say that he's managed to achieve something.
Yeah, and you know, David, let me put you on this. Because the New York Times is reporting that Donald Trump's tweet, like framed tweet to Kim Jong-un, actually caught his diplomatic corps in Asia and even his own advisors off guard. Particularly since their last meeting didn't go well. It ended as a disaster.
Laura, yeah, can you believe how cute she looks?
And they got nothing.